whole bunch of seeds. We are called as followers of Jesus Christ to do the exact same thing. We are called to die to our own wants and desires, to die to our own ways of thinking. We are called to die in order to bear fruit for the Lord. Our focus should always go beyond what God wants for us and what God wants for God's world. And folks, we ain't doing it today, y'all. I almost posted again on Facebook a meme I had posted 3 years ago because it was James Hetfield and Kirk Hammett playing the Star Spangled Banner at a ball game. And they played it well. For those of you who don't know who James and Kirk are, they're the guitarists of Metallica. If you don't know who Metallica is, it's one of the best bands on the planet, right? And they're playing it, and I'm listening to it again because it's that good. And I love our Star Spangled Banner. How many of you love the National Anthem? Yeah, it's really cool. And it fits our whole profile so well. Saber rattling and warmongering, you know, because it's a war song. The bombs bursting in air. And then it says, the land of the free and the home of the brave. And I'm like, when did we lose that? Because we're not brave at all. We're scared out of our minds. We act that way. We have substituted kindness for cruelty, and we've allowed it, and we wring our hands, and we talk about things as if we are helpless. And that's not true. We are not helpless. We have one power that has not yet been taken away from us, and that's the power to vote. If we don't like the way things are going, we get to vote. If we do like the way things are going, we get to vote. greatest followed Jesus Christ because the church kept their mouth shut when the atrocities began. When they started rounding up the gays and the gypsies, that was okay, they're not us. Then they started rounding up the people with mental retardation and mental illness, that was okay, it wasn't us. Then they started rounding up the Jews. And we always talk about the 6 million Jews, and we conveniently forget about the 6 million others that were killed. Because good people shut their mouths and looked the other way. And we as followers of Jesus Christ are called to bring light and life and mercy and grace to people. Not fear, not condemnation, but grace and mercy. That's what we're called to do. People go, oh, the Europeans, they don't go to church. Well, why should they? The church abandoned the most desperate people in their time of need. Did you know that in this country, Dutch people could not speak Dutch in the 1900s because they should be speaking English? That was the law of this state. And Ireland said, yeah, let's vote for that, and voted people in that would vote allow that. Voting has consequences, folks. And yet, this very congregation spoke German until shortly after World War I. And these were people that had settled here 40 years prior. And then they screamed in the new people's face, learn English! Shoot, we don't speak it well. How can you be a seed doing Christ's command if you're busy screaming at other people instead of showing them grace and mercy? Anne Frank's parents applied for a visa to the United States and were turned down. We know what happened to Anne Frank's family. Nothing has changed for people that are rattled to get in here. They will only to certain death, and we don't care. Because we got ours. The one that irritates me the most, and I'm going to get this off my chest and call it a day, is when people write, well, parents that are in prison are separated from their children. So you break the law and you get your family torn apart, right? That's the thinking. Heard it said too many times that it's not a one-off. United States, especially in Iowa, because I'm real intimately. I know where Amy is. She's in Mitchellville. She gets to write letters to her daughter because she knows where her daughter is. Her daughter gets to go visit her and gets to talk to her through the phone. She gets to talk to her through the internet on email. There's a help available. She gets to write her letters and send her pictures. Yeah, we're separated. But also, Amy wasn't trying to save her life and doing something that we considered illegal. She was selling drugs. She was causing people's illness and addiction. Big difference. And to compare parents who are facing a certain death, it'd be like standing at the border of Egypt and telling Mary, Joseph, and Jesus, you can't come in. Go back to Bethlehem. Yeah, Herod ordered all the little kids to die, but, well, that's Herod. He must be here because God wants him there. What a frock. good, kind people. I see people that I love dearly, that I care about dearly.